low thoughts will come and go. Don't mind them. Through God's grace, as a result of constant practice, you will get strength. Devote your whole mind to japa, meditation, worship, and study of the scriptures, whichever appeals to you for the time being. Mere mechanical japa does not help much. You must have love for the Lord. But then, even mechanical japa has some results. After all, it is the Lord's name that is being repeated. Pray to the Lord for strength, knowledge, and dispassion. Pray to Him with all your heart for His grace and for devotion and faith. It is not possible for everyone to practice hard austerities, but then through prayer, everything is attained. What kind of devotion takes us to God? The child's devotion to the mother. Why does the baby go to the mother? Because it has reasoned out that the mother is the best friend it has. And why do you go to God? Because you have previously reasoned out that God will help you and no one else can. So as the baby goes to the mother, you will go to God. So long as we have no ideal to follow, we will have to heed the calls of our lower nature. A characterless man is a slave to all worldly enjoyments. You have been worshipping this God of your body for so many lives. It is not easy to begin worship the true God all at once. If you would raise yourself, you must crucify the body and conquer the senses. The spiritual path for the present age lies through the harmony of all paths of earlier ages. Harmony of knowledge, devotion, and selfless work. We must have all these. We must have knowledge, devotion, and service. It won't do to have only one. In this age of Kali Yuga, one thing that counts is the Lord's name. Go on repeating His name. Just repeat His name for 108 times. That will bear fruit in time. Try to increase the number slowly. No work should be considered degrading. All works are of the Lord. Swamiji Himself used to clean the vessels. When you sweep the floor or dress vegetables, think that you are doing the God's work. Initiation into a mantra helps concentration of mind. The mind is susceptible to suggestions. It learns whatever you teach it. If through discrimination you can impress upon it the joy and fullness of life in the spirit and the folly of worldly attachments, then your mind will devote itself more and more to God. The way of studying and purifying the mind is to retire into solitude, control all cravings, and engage yourselves in contemplation and meditation. Work and worship must go hand in hand. Why are you afraid of work? Work for God. You can overcome all disinclination for work if you consider it as a dedication to God. One should not ask for anything from God, but remain satisfied with whatever He is pleased to give. Whatever situation one may be in, one can, to some degree, serve the motherland, serve the common people, and above all, serve God. Always have the good of the universe at heart, and let this become a part of your daily prayer. One who can detach his mind from material things will see the light of God and His presence in everything. Worldly attachment draws people away from God and scorches them in the wildfire of the world. never pride yourself on your having gained control over the passions. If you do, they will at once raise their heads. Ever pray to God, O Lord, save me from them. Nothing short of complete self-surrender to Him will do. You call Him the inner controller, the omniscient, the omnipresent, Antaryami, and yet you are afraid to surrender yourself to Him. Never expect anything from anyone, but always give. Otherwise, a sense of dryness will overtake you. But you must not give your mind to anyone. That you must give only to God. Work done in the spirit of service can surely lead us to the goal, as the meditation and japa will. To follow the master means to practice what he taught. Otherwise, nobody can advance by just offering him a few flowers or through some momentary sentimental outbursts. Can one become a great devotee of God simply by dancing and jumping or by quoting plentifully from the scriptures? What is wanted is freedom from selfishness, freedom from egoism. Mere talk will not do. This is an age of action. Not mere theory. Actualize it. There has been enough talk and writing. Put the books aside and let your actions speak. This is what the lives of Master and Swamiji stand for. The poor, the weak, the fallen, the ignorant. All these you have to make your own. And yet I warn you that in loving one section of the society, you must not become hateful of the other, the rich.